All right, moving on. Last week, almost all the JFK assassination files were declassified for the public. There's still a few hundred left, and the president now says those will come out once names and addresses of former or current agents are redacted. So who killed JFK? Was Lee Harvey Oswald acting alone? Was it what's in those last documents? We spoke to the man who's had the nation's top security clearance for 25 years, a man who's seen every document in the government's JFK file. Heck, he's the one who decided what to release in the first place. And he is right in our backyard. Is it true that the president's brain was missing at some point?
Well, that's an interesting question.
That is the Honorable John Tunheim, a federal judge in Minneapolis, also the chairman of the JFK Assassination Records Review Board in the 1990s.
Final report of our work.
How was that formed? Why?
The movie JFK was out in 1991.
Why was Kennedy killed? Who benefited? Who has the power to cover it up?
And then Stone came on in a trailer at the end of the movie when it was in the theaters and said, everything in this movie is proven by files that the government is hiding from you. Write your congressman. And people flooded Congress with demands to open the files. And so Congress passed this law requiring the executive branch to set up this process to review the files and to release whatever could be released.
Were you able to review, like, everything that was top secret?
Well, everything that, yeah, we had the highest security clearance so that we could see everything, because agencies were required to turn everything over to us, and then they would make arguments to us as to whether records should be released or should be protected.
So you literally hold all the secrets that people are so fiending right now?
Absolutely. I mean, all the records, the remaining 300 or so records that have redactions on, those redactions were placed by the review board.
You guys.
Yeah.
Based on everything that you've read, which is the whole file that has been held secret, do you believe that President Kennedy's assassination was a conspiracy or done by a lone gunman?
Well, I think, first of all, the only hard evidence supports Oswald. It was his rifle. His prints are all over it. He worked in the building. He was in the building during the assassination. The bullets in the vehicle that hit President Kennedy were tied to that gun. I mean, this is all evidence that would have convicted Oswald beyond a shadow of a doubt in court.
Yeah.
So I think he was the sole shooter that day.
But then why Jack Ruby?
That's probably the best evidence of a conspiracy is Ruby.
There are so many entities with interests in seeing JFK's demise, which makes the conspiracy so plausible.
Right.
There was the CIA, there was Cuba, there was the Mafia, there were the Teamsters, there was Russia. I mean, it was everywhere.
A lot of enemies.
LBJ, perhaps, was another theory.
He had a lot of enemies, yeah. But, you know, when you actually look at the mass of evidence through the years, there's no evidence of a conspiracy.
There is something else in the newly released files that has nothing to do with JFK, but with Adolf Hitler. The document says a trusted friend of a CIA agent in Venezuela met with a former Nazi SS soldier in 1955, who told him he regularly met with Adolf Hitler. Now, Adolf Schrittelmeier, this 10 years after Hitler's apparent suicide, this photo is dated 1954.
Why is that in the file, and what the heck?
I remember that. I'm not sure why it got caught up in the files. It may be the CIA agent in question was someone who all of that agent's files were collected as part of the assassination investigation.
Is it true? Did Hitler fake his death and escape Germany for South America? We don't know. The CIA dumped their efforts to prove it. But what is important is that these once secret files are now out in the open for a free society to view.
Because in the end, I think someone needs to make the statement that there's nothing being hidden anymore by the federal government concerning the Kennedy assassination. And I think that'll be an important day.
Wow. So anybody who follows the Kennedy assassination knows the Warren Commission. And they said, essentially, they concluded there was a lone gunman, Lee Harvey Oswald, and that was it. But there was another committee. It was a House Select Committee on Assassinations in the 1970s that concluded it was likely a conspiracy. So there was a government investigation that concluded something totally different, but they couldn't prove it.
I just think no matter what's released, it's not going to stop people from believing what they want to believe.
There's so many plausible conspiracies out there. You can't, I mean, it's not hook, line, and sinker, but there's so many plausible things. There was a mafia boss who died, not too long ago, who on his deathbed, 4 days before he died, was like, yeah, we killed the Kennedys. That's what he said. The New Orleans boss did it. Oh, by the way, his brain missing?
Yeah.
It's still missing from the National Archives, part of it. Nobody knows where it is.
And why don't we just throw Hitler in there to...
why not?
Goodness gracious.
Live and well in Venezuela.
We'll be right back.